SQL, NoSQL, relational, non-relational, table, collection, row, document, column, field. What does it all mean? Stick around. In this short video, I'm going to explain it all and hopefully help you decide which database to learn and use in your next project. Hi, I'm Jesse. I'm a senior developer advocate at MongoDB. So what is MongoDB? Well, first you need to understand how SQL and NoSQL databases work. These are also referred to as relational or non-relational. So let's talk about the OG database. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. It's a relational database. The easiest way to understand how SQL data is structured is by comparing it to an Excel spreadsheet. In relational databases like SQL, data is stored in rows and columns. Each row is a record and each column is a record field. In this example, we're storing user data. We have an ID, first name, last name, email address, physical address, and phone number. It seems pretty straightforward, but what happens when we want to add another email address to this user? Well, we'll have to add another column called email2. Then if for some reason there's a third email address, then we'll need to add a column called email3. Now let's add another record. This one only has one email address, so the second and third columns are going to be blank. We'll have the same issues with adding multiple physical addresses and phone numbers. Then let's add some more records. You can see how this is getting out of control quickly. The database is getting bloated with these empty fields. Now, because of this, relational databases separate related data into their own tables. We can extract the email address, physical address, and phone number columns and put them in their own table, which is tied back to the original table record with an ID. This is where the term relational comes from. The data in these tables are related. So now we have multiple tables relating back to the original table of records. If we want to get the information for one record, we now have to access multiple tables and join the data back together. Then there's schemas. Schemas define how the structure or blueprint of how our data should look. Schemas in SQL are strict, meaning that the data field types must be defined ahead of time. Adding additional columns or fields to tables affects all of the rows and records in that table and can result in bloated tables and failed queries if they're not updated properly. And when it comes to scaling, most SQL databases only scale up vertically, and those that can scale horizontally are difficult to configure. This means that you have to upgrade to larger, more expensive servers as your database grows. So why do things have to be so complex? Let's go back in time.
SQL databases have been around since the 1970s and were mainly focused on reducing data duplication since disk storage was very expensive back then. Here's a picture of an IBM 5 megabyte hard drive. This is the main reason why it's structured in a tabular format.
Because of all of this, SQL is difficult to understand structurally. It's hard to make changes to the data structure because of the rigid schemas. It's inefficient because of multiple tables being queried, and it's more expensive due to the vertical scaling. So now let's take a look at NoSQL or non-relational databases. Most refer to NoSQL as meaning not SQL, but it can also be referred to as not only SQL. In any case, the point is that NoSQL databases are structured differently than SQL databases. Then there's relational versus non-relational terminology. Generally, NoSQL databases are referred to as non-relational because they don't store data in related tables like SQL does. A big misconception is that non-relational databases cannot store relational data. Relational data can be stored in NoSQL databases. It's just stored differently. There are several types of NoSQL databases. There are key value databases, wide column stores, graph databases, and document databases. MongoDB is a document database. Instead of using tables, rows, and columns, document databases store data in documents. Specifically, JSON, JavaScript Object Notation Structured Documents. If you're familiar with JavaScript objects, then you're going to be right at home with NoSQL data structures. JSON is structured as objects containing key value pairs. We define an object with curly braces. Then our key is surrounded by quotes. And lastly, our value is separated from the key by a colon. The value can be a string surrounded by quotes, a number without quotes, arrays of values using square brackets, or even another object. From our previous example of user data, we now have a user record formatted as JSON data. We have our underscore ID, first name, last name, email, address, and phone number. When we have multiple values, we can just use an array to define them. So for the email value, we can define that as an array of email addresses. Then we can do the same for the addresses and phone numbers. So we see here that a single document stores all the data for each record instead of splitting up the data. Generally, data that is accessed together stays together. Although the documents that you work with are in JSON format, MongoDB actually stores the data on the server in BSON format. BSON is an extension of JSON and adds support for expanded data types. Now, the schemas within MongoDB are very flexible. By default, there are no rules in place. You can store any type of data in any document. This is by design. If you want more structure, it can be added at any time. And the scaling in MongoDB is very cost-effective. Instead of vertical scaling only, NoSQL databases generally scale horizontally. That means that instead of going up to a more expensive server, you can utilize multiple cheaper servers at a fraction of the cost. Now, because of the structure, this type of database is very efficient, easy to understand, and easy to modify and update. Let's take a look at some terminology differences between SQL and NoSQL. So in SQL, a cluster is a cluster in NoSQL. And in SQL, we have a database. Also in NoSQL, we have a database. But here's where the differences come in. In SQL, we have tables, but in NoSQL, we have collections. In SQL, we have rows, but in NoSQL, we have documents. In SQL, a column is in NoSQL a field. Now let's take a look at the MongoDB ecosystem. We're going to get a high-level overview of each part. So first we have self-hosted. This option will allow you to host your own MongoDB server on your hardware. This requires that you manage your server, updates, and any other maintenance. You can download and use the MongoDB open source community server on your hardware for free. Next, we have Atlas. So if you don't want to go the old school route of managing all of this on your own, you need MongoDB Atlas. Atlas utilizes a software as a service approach, and it's a global cloud database as a service for modern applications. With it, you can deploy a fully managed MongoDB server across AWS, Google Cloud, and Azure with best-in-class automation and proven practices that guarantee availability, scalability, and compliance with all of the most demanding data security and privacy standards. Compass is the GUI for MongoDB. It's available on Linux, Mac, or Windows. It allows you to visually explore your data, run ad hoc queries in seconds, interact with your data with full CRUD functionality, view and optimize your query performance, and make smaller decisions about indexing, document validation, and much more. MongoDB Atlas Search makes it easy to build fast, relevant full-text search capabilities on top of your data in the cloud, available exclusively with MongoDB Atlas. With Search, you'll get a Lucene-powered search engine, typo tolerance with fuzzy searching, autocomplete, filters and facets, custom scoring, and much more. MongoDB Charts is a modern data visualization tool that is integrated with the MongoDB Cloud Data Platform. Charts is the quickest, easiest, and most powerful way to visualize MongoDB data for real-time insights, business intelligence, and embedded analytics. With Atlas Online Archive, you can tier your data across fully managed databases and cloud object storage and query it through a single endpoint. Automatically archive historical data and save on operational and transactional data storage costs without compromising on query performance. Now that you understand the basics of how MongoDB works, let's learn more about Atlas, the fully managed cloud database. Be sure to sign up for a free account at mongodb.com. In the next video, we'll create our first Atlas cluster and load some sample data. If this video was helpful, be sure to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.